guys, welcome back to my channel. I have a very fun video for you guys today. I'm going to be sharing with you guys, I guess you could call it my holy grail makeup products, my essentials, current favorites, actually and even old favorites. These are 8 makeup products that I really rely on. Some of this stuff, if you've been with me for a while, some of it you will have heard about before, but I think there's a couple in here that you may be surprised by. I'm not sure that I have mentioned them, or if I have, that when I mentioned them, I felt as strongly as I do about them right now. I'm talking too much. Let's get into the video. I think it's going to be a lot of fun. Hopefully you guys are excited about it as well. Before we jump in, I want to welcome any new visitors to my channel. Hope that you enjoy this video, and if you do, please be sure to give it a thumbs up and make sure that you are subscribed before you leave. And with that said, let's jump right in. All right, you guys, as I mentioned, there are 8 products here in front of me. Let's start off with number 1, and that is a foundation. I know that you guys have probably heard about this before. It is the L'Oreal Infallible Fresh Wear Foundation. I've become so dependent upon this foundation over the last year. It is easily the most transfer-proof foundation in my collection, and as spring and summer approaches, anyone else out there really excited about summer? I mean, we're barely having spring weather. The grass is just barely starting to green. I think we hit 55 the other day. I'm rambling. My point in saying that is, as I look forward to summer, I really look forward to this foundation in the summertime because it holds up so, so well on my skin. I know I've talked a lot about this foundation on and off over the last, probably the last year and a half, but especially in the last 6 or 8 months, I've especially fallen in love with this stuff. I do have to make sure my skin is very well hydrated before I put this on, so I always add either an extra layer of moisturizer or a moisturizing primer, but as long as I do that, I don't find that it dries my skin out. It holds up really well, has a really good skin-like leaning satin finish, but I wouldn't necessarily call it a matte finish. I think there's a lot of different skin types that might get along with this foundation. If you do have dry skin, just make sure that you use a hydrating primer underneath, or perhaps even a little bit of like a priming oil if you're really, really dry, and then I think you might like this, and you'll definitely love the longevity of this stuff. So the next 2 things are brow products that I kind of use in combination with each other. I have mentioned them both separately before, but I have really fallen in love with this method of doing my brows. So let's start with this one. It is the e.l.f. Shape and Stay Brow Wax Pencil. I have been talking about this little wax stick for a couple of years now, probably 2.5 or 3 years. Initially when I talked about this, I mentioned this as a good brow setter, but I actually don't use it for that anymore because this is not long-term gonna set your brows in place. What I love to use this for now is this is the very first thing that I will put in my brows. I'm gonna put a little clip here for you guys showing you how I just quickly throw this in my brows. I will just give one little swipe on each brow, then I'll take the back end of a spoolie and just really brush my brows upright. And it does a couple of things for me. It makes my brows stay where I need them to stay, especially as I go in with a pencil or even a brow gel. It's almost like a brow hair trainer. My brows naturally want to be straight sideways, so it takes a lot of work for me to get them to go upright, and this is such a great product to do that and help them to stay that way, which also then helps me when I'm filling them in because I can actually see where the sparse areas are. I can see the shape of my brows and how I want them to look before I even start filling them in. And as a third bonus, it adds a little bit of texture and kind of thickness or fluff to my brows. So if you like that kind of caterpillar or fluffy brow look, or maybe you have thinner brow hairs and you want something that's going to give them like some volume. I don't know if that makes sense. I feel like this does that for me. It almost gives my brows volume, if that's a thing. I feel like it is, and I love it. And in combination with the brow stick, third, I have my Ulta Beauty Ultra Slim Brow Pencil. I know I've talked a lot about this, and I feel like I've been re-talking a lot about this recently. I know that was not grammatically correct. I'm sorry. Been a long time fan of this brow pencil. It is fantastic. It is going on sale soon, the Ulta Beauty sale, actually. I believe it's the start of week 3 of the Ulta Beauty sale. This is such a good brow pencil. It is the perfect stiffness. It's the perfect size and shape. It's the perfect color. This one is the shade Ash Taupe, which works so perfectly for my brows. But I believe they have quite a few shades in this brow pencil. It is so, so good. If you get this during the sale, you'll be able to find it for half price, which is $5. Normally, it's $10, which I think is a little steep for a drugstore brow pencil, but man, if you can find this for $5 or even $7.50, it's fantastic. I absolutely love this thing. Moving on to my 4th holy grail makeup essential. This is not a very exciting, a very sexy product. It's something that I use a lot, and I don't, even on camera, I use it when I'm doing a full makeup look, and sometimes I don't even show this product. It is the Rimmel Stay Matte Powder. I have 2 of these that look about like this. They're like 50% panned. Part of me wants to pick up a new one, but I really do want to like use up the rest here on the side. You guys, I love this stuff. From the beginning of my channel, if you've watched me for a while, I've always been kind of a non-powder fan. Okay, let me rephrase that. For a long time, I was not a fan of powder because I do have dry skin. I have a lot of fine lines. I'm almost 40, so kind of comes with the territory. Some of you know how that goes. As you get close to 40, you get a lot of lines on your face, and any amount of powder, I feel like, can really emphasize those. And I just don't like generally how the feel of a heavy powder is on my skin. This is not a heavy powder, though. This is a very, very fine, lightweight, almost imperceptible powder. And it does do a really good job of setting down areas of my makeup that I need to be set down. So I do have forehead wrinkles that I don't like when my foundation settles into. I mean, pretty much anything settles into them, but this helps minimize the settling significantly. I also sometimes like to put it on the sides of my nose, especially if it's in warmer weather, and here along my smile lines. Same thing, it does a good job of setting my makeup down, but it doesn't feel like I'm wearing powder at all. And I have noticed over time that adding just a tiny bit of powder to your makeup does help your makeup stay in place longer. That's something I've heard people talk about for years. Because I don't like heavy powder on my skin, I never gave powder a chance, or I figured I'd rather my makeup wear off than have really dry, cracky, liney skin. But more and more, I'm kind of converting over to using just a little bit of powder in my daily routine, and this is my most used powder, my powder of choice. Let's move on to Holy Grail item number 5, and it is the Thrive Cosmetics Liquid Lash Extensions Mascara. I could not mention this mascara, and I have another example to share with you guys. So we were at a baseball game yesterday, sitting outside in a very pretty stiff cold breeze blowing directly in my face, and my eyes were watering like crazy. I mean, crazy eye watering happening, and I honestly was sitting doing this for 3 hours straight. They were watering so severely that I had my doubts that even this, that I have long praised for its ability to hold up on watery eyes, the amount that my eyes were watering, I was sure that some of this would have worn off in the corners. But when I got back in my car, I took a look. My mascara looked like I had just put it on. Now, the eye makeup underneath was a different story, but my mascara was completely intact. It looked amazing, and I was just once again astounded at how budge-proof this mascara is. And the most amazing thing about this, I've tried other mascaras that are very waterproof, but the ones that really hold up, they're very, very hard and uncomfortable and crusty feeling on your eyes. I don't know if you guys know what I'm talking about. If you tried out really intense waterproof mascara, it feels like you have needles coming out of your eyeballs. And then when you go to remove it at night, it is such a pain to get off. This stuff does not feel that way on your eyes, and it also is very easy to remove. This stuff is amazing and totally worth it. The sixth product that I had to mention as a Holy Grail is one that has been a long time Holy Grail, and if you've been with me for a while, this is probably the product that most defines me, but I had to mention it today because it is still considered an absolute essential for me. It is the Wet n Wild Kohl Liner in Simma Brown. Now, I know a lot of you guys have tried this liner out because of my recommendation, because I've been talking about this liner since day one of my channel, which was like 3 years ago, and I still love this stuff. This is a pretty basic pencil. There's nothing wildly miraculous about this pencil. I'm not even quite sure why it works so well for me. I think it's a combination of a couple of things. I think number one, I've been using it for so long that I'm just so comfortable with working with this specific pencil that when I try out other pencils that I don't use regularly, I almost always just want to go back to this one right here. It does a good job of, I wouldn't say it's long wearing. I know I've said this before, but again, I know there are some new people here that haven't heard me rave about the Wet n Wild liner, so we're gonna do it again today. Please bear with me. It is not long wearing, but it doesn't tend to smudge or melt on me. It also, if it does wear off, it wears off very gracefully. But I wouldn't even say this really wears off on me very much. I definitely still see it in place at the end of the day, unless of course I'm in the situation that I was in yesterday at a baseball game where my eyes are basically two water faucets. It's not going to hold up to that, but just to everyday wear, it wears so well on me. It's creamy, but also not too creamy. I like that it has a subtle stiffness to it that just makes it easier to kind of manipulate. Sharpens really well. It doesn't dull down as fast to some of those, like, you know, the gel liners, like the Urban Decay 24/7 liner. Those ones are almost too creamy for me. They apply so much product to my eyes that it just feels like a little bit too much. This one's just the right consistency, and I love the shade of it. And it's 98 cents. Who doesn't love that it's 98 cents? So there it is again. I'm sorry if you're tired of hearing me rave about this. I'll try and keep it to once a year. We'll try and only rave about the Wet n Wild once a year. So I'm good for 2021. For my ninth Holy Grail or essential makeup item that I just can't live without, this is a new one. This is one that I contemplated maybe I should give this a little bit more time before I put this in the video, but I have talked about it before in a favorites video. It is the Urban Decay All Nighter Setting Spray. I love this stuff. I have a travel version right here, and it's running very low. I do think this stuff works. It does make your makeup last longer, and I do think that it helps your makeup not transfer quite so much under a mask. So I've been using this daily for the last probably couple of months, and I've noticed significantly that the inside of my masks, which are usually white, don't look nearly as caked with makeup as they were before using this. I know there are a lot of other people out there that consider this a holy grail as well. I would love to know if any of you have found a drugstore dupe for this that works as well at like locking your makeup down. I love a lot of other setting sprays. I love the L'Oreal one. I love the ColourPop Pretty Fresh setting spray. I really like the Catrice one as well, but I don't feel like they lock my makeup down as much. I don't know if it's just like the alcohol that this one has in it. So if you know of an alternative, let me know. I haven't always been a big setting spray fan, or maybe not necessarily not a fan, but it's just a step that I often skip. But I've just really come to rely on this stuff lately. I was actually hoping that this would go on sale during the 21 Days of Beauty. They did have the all-nighter primer go on sale, but I don't really have an interest in that. I imagine I'm just gonna have to bite the bullet and buy a full size of this sometime soon, and then maybe this fall or the next Sephora sale, I'll try getting it for a sale price, or even better, maybe one of you will have a drugstore dupe for this that I can try out and we'll find that it works just as well. All right, we are down to my 10th holy grail or essential makeup item. This is one that I have also mentioned a few times recently, but I have a newfound love for it for even a different reason. And it is the Milk Makeup Lip and Cheek Stick in the shade Work. So I talked about this initially as a blush. This was actually an accidental product that I got as a birthday gift. I never had an intention of picking this thing up. The only product from Milk that I had ever tried at that time was the Milk Makeup Bronzer Stick, which I do love. I think my love for this thing is actually surpassing my love for the Milk Makeup Bronzer Stick, which I do still love. Don't get me wrong, but I have been die hard in love with this. I love it for my cheeks. It is such a perfect shade for my skin tone, but as much as I love this for my cheeks, I have learned to love this even more for my lips. It is amazing. This is basically like it's like a cross between a lip balm and a traditional lipstick. It's not quite as heavy or as thick as a lipstick. It feels more like a balm, but it gives a good amount of color. This specific shade is the exact color of my lips if they were looking a little bit healthier. This is truly the type of product, you know the phrase, your lips but better. That's exactly what this stuff is for me personally. I love the formula of it. It's very, very comfortable. It's very hydrating, but it's not overly thick. It's the perfect thing to wear when you're wearing masks around and you don't really want like lip product all over. Definitely not anything gloopy. It is so, so good. So I'm gonna insert a clip for you guys of this on my cheeks. I'll show you how it looks kind of before and after and just with the application putting this on. I do love it as a cheek product. It's such a pretty color. And then I'll insert you guys a little clip here of this on my lips. And I honestly just put it on like a lip balm. This is the perfect product to throw in your bag. It has a perfect lid. It's a twist-off lid. This is the mini size, and I actually love the mini size because if it was the huge size, kind of like the bronzer stick, let me just grab that. So this is the full size of the bronzer stick. I don't know if the blush would be the same size, although I have seen the mini of the bronzer, and it is this size. So my guess is that the full size of this is probably this size, which I feel like is a little weird as a lip product. So even though the value for the amount of product with this one, it is $15, is not quite as good as this one, which I believe is $28 for probably four times the amount of product. I still like the convenience of this size, and I already feel like I want to buy another one of these just in case they discontinue this before I am able to restock. I mean, I haven't even close used all of this thing up, but I love it so much and I have been using it so much that I just don't ever want to be without this thing. It is so, so good. And along with these other products, one of the things that I reach for almost on a daily basis. And with that, you guys, those are my 8 essential or holy grail items that I absolutely rely on. Granted, I know some of these are not very exciting to talk about. They're not very glamorous or fun, but I use these all the time and I rely on them to make sure my makeup looks good and stays in place. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. I would love to know from you guys, what would you say is your top 2 holy grail or essential makeup items? Let me know down in the comments below. I want to remind you one more time, if you enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and also make sure that you subscribe to my channel before you leave. But that is all I have for you guys today. Thank you again for stopping by. I hope that you guys are doing well and I will see all of you in my next video. Bye.
Oh, that was so sweet. Love a hug. You're the best. Mm-hmm.